Hello, I'm Matt Edmondson, and welcome to The F Factor. Thank you for coming back. Great show this week. Coming up, we'll take a look back at last weekend's shows, get your opinions, chat to John, and exclusively preview next week's Halloween special. But before all of that, let's talk about Saturday night. Danny forgot the name of the show.
Wow, Factor.
Simon revealed what it will take for Dermot to get the job presenting the American X Factor.
More than a smooch, Dermot.
And Paige decided on an unexpected career change.
I'm taking quite a big risk because I'm stripping.
All right, it's a family show. Now, the thing this week was guilty pleasures, and it turned out that almost everyone's guilty pleasure was red hair dye. Yes, Cheryl, Rebecca, Trake, and Cher had all hit the bottle. It's a strong look. But the biggest change in appearance this week came from Paige, who'd grown sideburns and dyed them blue. Holding me close. Now, Rebecca's hair seemed to be causing her a little bit of trouble, as it kept flopping in front of one of her eyes. What she needs is Harry Styles' trademark hair removal maneuver. You know the one, you just wait for the camera to be far enough away, and then use your hand to swish it to one side. It's simple, but effective. Even Trake's mastered it.
Thanks, Daniel.
So, in your own time, Rebecca, just give it a go. Right, go for it. Anytime now. Anytime right now. Because the camera's cut away, so just do it now. Just before the camera cut... Oh, no. Maybe next time. Thanks anyway, though, Harry. Who has he learnt that from? Now, I really like One Direction, especially Zayn, or as I like to call him, the Human Echo. Nobody likes... Nobody likes to lose their inner voice. That could be really annoying.
That could be really annoying.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Biscuits.
Biscuits.
Despite all her hair trouble, Rebecca gave a great performance and even managed to smuggle a dwarf onto the stage. Meanwhile, Trake popped her dress in some bleach just in time for Katie's performance. Matt performed without his hat.
It's only a hat.
And John found himself caught up in a love triangle with Mary and Wagner.
I was next to Mary and she just grabbed my hand and was just like, John, don't you let go, young man.
They were actually getting it on in the corner.
And that reminds me, I wonder if Louis got that letter that I sent him last week. You know, the one complaining about how he always gets Wagner's name wrong. Remember, from last week...
Last week! It's Wagner!
Louis getting everyone's names wrong has rubbed me up the wrong way.
Wagner.
So I've decided to write him a strongly worded letter.
Put your stamp on.
Yeah, that's pretty much what happened. But did it work?
It's Wagner!
No, maybe the letter got lost in the postal system. To be fair, I should have just given it to one of the contestants to hand on, because apparently they're quite good when it comes to, you know.
You always deliver.
You deliver every single
deliver.
You've delivered. Thank you so much for delivering.
Thank you.
Amazing delivery. You delivered on that.
I thought you delivered it really well.
Don't deliver it.
Now, I've been watching Louis for quite some time, and I've noticed that whenever he sat behind the judging desk, he's always holding on to his pen. But what is he writing down? Well, after some investigative research, I can reveal that it's so he can...
Tick every single box.
Every single box. Single box. Single...
Yes, Louis's been in the music industry for years and has a checklist of things that he looks out for. When he sees them, he gives them a little tick in a box, and if he fills up all of the boxes, he knows that he's found himself a brilliant recording artist. Touch it, stroke it, and undress it. I can see every part, nothing hides in the heart to hurt me.
You tick every single box. I think you'd be a brilliant recording artist.
But sadly, Cheryl wasn't quite as impressed as Louis.
If you had added maybe some of the Connie to it.
Oh yes, Connie is in the presenter of The Extra Factor. I'm sure that she'd have absolutely loved that.
Absolutely.
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 That was absolutely ridiculous.
And with that, Saturday was over. But where were you? Obviously, don't answer that. Can't hear you. I do, however, know that one group of people got together with some wall charts, some chicken nuggets, and a genie to enjoy the show, and we were there lurking in the corner to film the whole thing.
Hi, I'm Jenny. Welcome to my X Factor party.
Hi, X Factor.
I'm sorry, it's about to chart. Every week we choose who it's going to win, or who our favourite is. Paige
bits and marry me.
I think it's a really good voice, but I'm really annoyed that Simon's putting his oar in about styling.
He has a Lionel Richie feel.
The dances were really unnecessary.
I thought she was really good. I thought she was really sultry.
I love Cher. Cher to win.
She's like Cheryl Cole 4 years ago. Terrible trucker heart.
I like Matt, but I just don't think he'll win.
What song are we singing?
Nobody knows.
I like Harry. I'm just in love.
Tracy's best so far.
Tracy has really blown me away.
She's got the voice of an angel.
I'm young and I love Mary.
I really like his microphone sound.
That's most interesting.
That version was a lot better than Girls Aloud.
Controversial.
Magnet, no, he's amazing. Yeah.
Look at his hand on Dermot's shoulder, it's massive.
Show me your front side.
I love
favourite, Rebecca.
When Aiden.
Ala, who's on the text?
Ah! Marvellous. And if you'd like some strangers to come and film you and your friends whilst you watch television, then please do get in touch. We are the F Factor at talkbackthames.tv. Right then, still to come, we're going to be catching up with the contestants to find out all about this week's show, and we'll be chatting to the eliminated act from Sunday night. Speaking of which, was it just me, or did Dermot look like he was about to win the lottery?
It's you!
Now, I love the Sunday Results Show, especially the bit where the judges are brought out, and it gives Dermot a lovely opportunity to pat the head of his imaginary dog.
Simon! Danny! Louis! Cheryl.
Now, as ever, there were guest performers, and this week we were treated to the sight of a bit of...
Bublé!
That's not what I meant. I, of course, meant everyone's favourite crooner and amazing handshaker, Michael Bublé, who's been on the show so many times he thinks he's a contestant. Yeah, I mean, after his performance, he even did his best vote for me face.
Michael Bublé!
There it is. Up next was a vocal treat from one of my favourite X Factor judges.
You've got the guilty pleasure!
I meant Cheryl, which brings us to this. Yes, Cheryl was finally blessed with her first experience of the Jesus light, which probably made it the best night of her entire life. But not everyone was so lucky. It was time to whittle the contestants down to the bottom two, but not before Simon and Matt had done their sexy faces. So, which two were in the sing-off?
John and Tracy.
Ooh, tough competition. I wonder what they'll choose to sing.
I'm going to sing Because of You by Kelly Clarkson.
Oh, I love that song, and it's always good for a sing-along. In fact, join in if you know the words.
Because of you, I never played. Everything because of you, I learned to just to anyone else.
And Trake sang this.
One night only.
Why?
It's because this is my one night.
Not a very optimistic outlook. So it was time to send either John or Trake home, but I think Louis got a bit confused.
Louis, coming to you first. The name of the act you're sending home tonight, please.
Eventually, Louis and Cheryl chose to save their own acts, and Danny chose to save John. So the final decision lay with Simon.
The person I'm gonna send home is John.
And with that, John left the competition, which is a shame because I think he still had a few sides of himself left to show us.
Yeah, and it's going to be nice to show that side of me.
It shows the fun side of John, you know? Yeah. Smiley side.
Different side to John.
Would you want people to see a different side of you?
He did have a lot of sides. In many ways, he was like a...
dodecahedron.
Yeah, that's the word. So, once John was out, we gave him a few minutes to recover before bombarding him with your questions.
Three, two, one. As outright winner goes, I would like to see Rebecca do really well. If I was a biscuit, I would probably be a hobnob. Ooh, my highest name.
Would probably be up here.
Damn, that's high. Salt and vinegar, mild, not too strong. She sells.
bleep.
She sells seashells on the seashore. They were talking about hacking off my hair, so I decided, no, let's go bigger, bigger, darling, bigger. I just wish I had longer hair so that Louis wouldn't want to cut it. Beyonce knows. Jay-Z, don't hate me, don't hate me. This one's for you now. John Adelaide! Wicked.
I'm gonna miss John, but I'm sure that with time, I'll learn to get over it. Yeah, I'm pretty much over it. So, what's happening this weekend?
Theme this week is
Halloween. And I am a pumpkin.
Lots of sort of Halloween-based songs.
Freaky stuff.
Some haunting melodies.
My song this week is a massively well-known Halloween song.
It's been covered a few times by different artists, but we want to make it our own.
The artist I've got this week is one of my heroes.
The song's quite a deep song.
It has a bit of a rhythm to it.
It's a great song, it's great for Halloween.
I hope it brings out the devilish side of me.
And I'm a massive fan of the band.
The song's quite high to sing.
They're on about bringing, not backing dancers, but backing ghosts.
It's time for people to hear me sing.
If it gets too scary, we could be going home.
Before I go on stage, I'm always really, really scared.
It's that moment before you go on must just be the worst moment.
To the point where people think I'm not going to be able to go on.
Nervous on the stage, 40 million people, bumbling.
Possibility of the public seeing you do really badly.
I want to be me, wear my heart on my sleeve and really believe in what I sing.
I'm having to take the key down, a couple of keys, having problems with my vocal cords.
I am never scared when I go on a stage.
With our girls singing, it might be a bit difficult, but you have to blast it out.
I love the stage.
I've got my workout.
I cannot wait, although sadly, because of the laws of time, I'm going to have to. Right then, that is pretty much it for this week's show. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, please feel free to send it on and share it with your friends. And of course, you can come and say hi to me on Twitter. I am at Matt Edmondson. Whilst you're there, if you ever want to highlight yourself to me, you can use the hashtag FFactor. We search through it and we can see all your questions and comments. And all the contact details for getting in touch with the show are down there right now. So if you've got a photo for the opening titles, or if you want to invite us to one of your X Factor parties, we would love to hear from you. I'm going to leave you now. There are some more clips to follow if you're really, really hungry for more. But here is the moment we've all been waiting for. It is the group performance. I will see you next Wednesday from 5:30. Take care. Bye-bye. I'm sorry, I can afford a Ferrari.
Tell your little boyfriend. I see you drive.